Hello guys, this is Roger 69501 and welcome to my channel. Well, on this video I'm gonna give you my thoughts for this 6-part story arc, which is on the books of Green Lanterns. Part 1 is Green Lantern issue number 9. Check out this cover. Great cover. Issue number 10. Check that out. Issue number 11. Look at that. Issue number 12. Look at that. And the last one. Green Lantern issue number 14. Check that out. Okay. So I'm gonna tell you what the Phantom Lantern is about. That's the name of this story. Okay. Let's get to it. Part 1. Issue number 9. Before I start, I'm gonna have my coffee. This story arc, it was really good. I love it. I mean, it has a lot of action, a lot of adventure. It has everything in it. Everything that you want in a, at least not that, I don't know about what you want, but what I want in a Green Lantern book, I got it on this story arc. Oh yeah. Okay. Issue number 9. Well, this is the beginning of the Phantom Lantern. You see, this guy here, okay, basically is kind of like a copy-paste of the life of Hal Jordan. More or less copy-paste. This guy was a pilot. He had trouble with his plane. And he was going to crash, and Hal Jordan came in and saved his life. Awesome art also. Check out that art. So he was so impressed by it, being saved by a Green Lantern, that he decided he doesn't want to be a pilot anymore. Although since he was a kid, he wanted always to be a pilot. You know that when you are a kid and you decide, oh, well, I want to be this, and you spend your whole life to reach that, to be that. So that was his dream when he was a kid, is to become a pilot in the Air Force. And he got to be a pilot. He was not into the pilot anymore after he got saved by Hal Jordan. So now, once he got saved by Green Lantern, in this case Hal Jordan, well, now he has a new purpose in life. I don't want to be a pilot anymore. Pilot what for? That's just boring. Always up and down. That's it. So he decides that he wants to become a Green Lantern. So he started to study what Green Lantern is all about. How a person can become a Green Lantern, how a Green Lantern can get a ring. So he gets to find out that only the ring choose the person. The person do not choose the ring. Easy enough. So he decides to work out. He wants to be worthy. So he's trying to do good, to be worthy for the ring, because he knew on his heart that if he will work hard on his life and physically and mentally, that eventually, that one day a ring will fly to him and choose him to be the next Green Lantern. You see, because he wants to be a superhero. So he chose most of the dangerous job. He even worked as a security, armed security guard in Arkham Asylum. safeguarding the Joker. I mean, come on. I mean, I will not have that job. Safeguarding the Joker? Me? Forget it. Nah. Oh no, not me. So he decides to be a superhero. We see him here. So we see that somebody is going to be attacked, but the thing is he got beat up big time. He got his ass handed to him. Look at that. So the thing is that he feel happy about it, to the point where he got so frustrated that he's talking, yelling to the wind. What do you want from me? Right there. He just so frustrated and all beat up, broken wrist, broken nose, swelling eye. And then suddenly, something came through the window. The ring. Look at that. He wishes came through, but not quite. Check that out. The ring sees him and says his name. Welcome to the Green Lantern Corps, Error. Welcome to the Error. Malfunction, deleted, recalibrating, rescanning, Frank Laminski. That's the name of the main character. You do not have the ability to overcome great fear. You have not been chosen. And the ring just flew away. I mean, and then after that, he gets real pissed off when he see the Justice League doing their job. He see the Jessica Cruz and Simon Baz as a Green Lantern. So he just frustrated by it. So just when he was going, kind of like, I don't know if he was going, when he was arriving to his kind of like an apartment maybe or empty building, there's somebody waiting for him. And happened to be this guy. This guy in a hoodie. There's been a lot of characters with a hoodie lately on this DC River. Look at it. Now, that person happens to be Voldoon. This is a character that the first time I heard about him was on the New 52, which happens to be the first Green Lantern ever. It's Voldoon. And that was the end of part one. I mean, don't be surprised if this video takes long because this story has so much information in it. It has so much story and history that it's gonna take time though. Okay, part two, issue number 10. Okay. Issue number 10, we see that the guy, his last name is Lewinsky, if I'm not mistaken. So he goes to a house. You know, he will get dressed up. He says, look, I need to borrow your house. And what he does is that, well, he just burned the house down. Well, not only that, the thing is that, you see, that ring that Voldoom is looking is the ring that one of the guardian has. Now, remember the video before this one, my last video, that there was a guardian that has like a phantom ring? Well, that's the ring that this story is about. The thing is that Simon takes the ring and he puts him on. The thing about the ring is that the ring is connected to the spectrum. All the feelings all combined in one. Talking about rage, avarice, fear, will, hope, compassion, and love. All those feelings at the same time, it can drive anybody crazy. I mean, because there's no way you can be sad and happy and hungry at the same time. You cannot eat and talk at the same time. So imagine having all those feelings having all those feelings at the same time, it's hard to be hell to deal with it. The thing is that some of us, he cannot deal with it. The thing is that, you see, Boldum, while he was talking to that guy, Lewinsky, I think it is, he promised him a ring. I said, look, I know that you want to become a Green Lantern. I know you can be a good one. I got the ring for you. And this, on this place, is on Simon Bass' house. Because Simon Bass' house is where this guardian is hiding with the Phantom Ring. So, Voldoom tells Lewinsky, look, I want you to go and get that ring. And that ring is going to be yours. But, you have to do things my way. And then eventually, once that you finish doing what you're supposed to do, then you're gonna be free with your ring and do whatever you want. And the guy says, hell yeah. So, now remember at the beginning of the story where I tell you that guy went to a house and said, well, I need to borrow your house. Well, he burned the house down. So that means that Simon Bass and Jessica Cruz, they flew to save where the house is at, on fire, to help people and all that. While all that's going on, we see the guy sneaking inside of Simon Bass' house, searching for the ring until he finds it. Look at that. Awesome art, I like the color. Once he has the ring, the guardian shows up. They say, what are you doing? Do not touch it. Can't touch this. And the guy says, well, I just touch it, I'm going to put them on. Not only that right before that this guardian was going to attack the guy to stop him wearing the ring, guess who shows up on that same house? Voldoom attacked the guardian. You see, Voldoom and this specific guardian, they were good buddies. They were good friends, a couple of billion years ago. So, they were good friends. Not only that on this story arc, you get a background where Voldoom comes from, and also a little bit of the guardian, why they were friends and why they become enemies. So, like I said before in the beginning of this video, that this story arc has a lot of history. So don't be surprised that this video is going to take long. I hope not, because I don't know how to edit it. So, sorry. Back to the story. So they are fighting. So that guy puts on the ring, and he becomes the Phantom Lantern. Check that out. Such a badass. Look at it. Just awesome. Look at that. Oh yeah. So now he's a badass Phantom Lantern. The thing is that depending how he feels, his uniform change shape and color. Right now he's a green lantern because he has a lot of will. So now he becomes a Green Lantern. So if something happened and he gets scared by something, he changed into yellow, fear, and so on and so forth. So he constantly changing back and forth. The thing is that Voldoom and the Phantom Lantern, they're getting into a little bit of an argument. You see, now that the guy becomes a Phantom Lantern, he got a little bit cocky. You know, like, well, you know, now I'm a lantern. Now I'm a hotshot now. You know, you can always call me Lethal Weapon or something. So he gets real cocky. And Voldoom, he doesn't like cockiness at all. So he kind of like, look, get off of your horse. Put your feet on the ground. This is not as easy as you think it is. You have to follow. Well, we had a deal. And the guy said, okay, fine. So, the fight stopped there. Part 3. Look at that. Issue number 11. No, so now that guy, he's still a Green Lantern. Now he decides to go to outer space, you know, because he wants to try. I would. The thing is that we see that he goes to outer space, he starts flying, he goes underwater, he goes to the Arctic. His name is Frank. So he just having fun with the ring. He's just doing stuff that he could never do as a regular pilot from the Air Force pilot. He could never do anything what he's doing right now with the ring. The thing is that suddenly a tornado shows up. He formed, actually, in Kansas. So we see the little kid. We see that the tornado pulled the kid into it. And Frank, that's the name of the Phantom Lantern, saved his life. Look at it. Not only that, at that moment, he stopped the tornado, everything. We see that Simon and Jessica, they are talking between them and say, look, how and when we're going to deal with this guy, how we can deal with this Phantom Lantern having all those feelings at the same time, that he can change color at will. The thing is that whoever wears the ring, he cannot control the ring. The ring control the person. It's the opposite of a Green Lantern. A Green Lantern, the ring choose the person, but the person is the one that controls the ring. That's why it's about will. You have to have a strong will to control the ring. With the Phantom Ring, it's the opposite. The Phantom Ring will control you. That's it. Regardless whether you have willpower or not, it doesn't matter. It will control you eventually. We see Jessica and Simon, they arrive where Frank is, where that tornado is at, because they're going to take the ring away from him. We see the newscast, just the right moment when they weren't going to stop fighting, the kids show up and save him. I did not save his life, but he just stopped it. He saved my life. Now, at this moment is when Frank, he feels like he's a superhero. He feels like he's one of the Green Lantern, he feels like he's part of the Green Lantern, for more than a Green Lantern, more like a hero. For the first time of his life, he feels like a hero. Maybe on his mind, he might be thinking, try to join the Justice League. I will not be surprised. And everybody's watching him. We see Ferris looking at the TV. Batman is looking at it, like saying, where did this guy come from? The thing is that suddenly he changed colors, his uniform. He turns energy. He becomes Phantom Lantern. Now check that out. Awesome. So, and then from there, he goes back to green. You see, because he cannot control it. The ring is controlling him. And right here is when he loses control. You can see that each panel has a different color. Well, that's the different color of the emotional spectrum. So each panel become fear, love, hate, compassion, and all that rage. So he's constantly changing. Talking about multi-personality bipolar. Must be hell. So here, finally, he becomes the Orange Lantern, Avaris. Check this out. Awesome, huh? Okay. Issue number 12. This is a long story. Here's a clear explanation about the big ring is the Phantom Ring. All the ring, the little ring, explains you what it's about. So here we see that he becomes Avaris and Simon and Jessica, they're going to engage him. Because the thing about this ring is that it fits on him. So So from there, we go years back when Frank was a young, when he was kind of like a young man on Cold City, when he's walking around with his girlfriend, and then some accident happened at the fair, and how Jordan shows up and saves the day. And then we see that his girlfriend kind of like got the hots for him. It's like he tells Frank, well, the guy is a real hero. So that's part of where Frankie decides that he wants to become a superhero. He wants to become a Green Lantern because he wants to get the attention of his girlfriend and everybody else anyway, for that matter. So we've seen that he's going through hell. He cannot control his ring. Check that out. And then we see Voldoom with... sorry about the glare. With the Guardian. The Guardian, he's pretty in a pretty bad shape. And this moment is when Frank, he says, I deserve this ring. It belongs to me. I am the Phantom Lantern. And Voldoom says, go out and prove it to me. So he kind of like challenged him. So we see that we are in Cold City. They are looking for the Phantom Lantern, but they don't get to find him. They're searching. The thing is that they go to a memorial park where we see kind of like a battery, like a Green Lantern battery with four statues, and then we see Voldoom there. Not Voldoom, but the Phantom Lantern right there. Okay, age 13. So there we see him that he's becomes so here we go back in time, about 10 billion years ago. That was just a couple of weeks ago anyway. We can see here Voldoom when he was human. He was the first lantern. The thing is that once he becomes the first lantern, he become cocky and he lose control and he become a bad guy. To make the long story short. And because of him, the Guardian decide to create the green rings that we can see here. Seven of them. To search throughout the galaxy, the worthy person that it will become Green Lantern to defeat Voldoom. Otherwise, he will take over the universe and the Guardians and everybody. So, this is more or less the origin of Voldoom. That's why, like I said, that this story has, that this story arc has a lot of history. Look at that. Awesome. Also tells you here that they become friends. So now we go back to Earth. We see that our heroes are fighting him with us when he becomes yellow. Look at that. So here is when the thing is that Frank, the Phantom Lantern, he tells Jessica and Simon, how the two of you are going to stop me? What makes you better than me? How about you, Jessica? You have no willpower. You're afraid. You don't even have the ability to create a construct. And you tell me that you're going to stop me? I don't think so. And also you, Simon Bass. I mean, you think just because you're not worthy either. What makes you better than me? What are you, a terrorist? I mean, you've been in jail. Give me a break. In Guantanamo. So what makes you worthy or better than me? And not only that, since when a Green Lantern wears a gun? So what is it with you? I mean, that's why I like the story arc. It kind of gets into the character's mind. he just kind of like pressed the, I mean, when he told that to, when the Phantom Lantern told what he says to them, he kind of like, he touched the nerve, and they get, one of them gets sad, the other one get confused, like, oh, wait a minute, how can this happen? So we go back to the house where we see Baldoom, where he has the guardian on the floor. So let's see what else, and then from there we see that there's the, this is the best part of the whole story. This is the story of the two of them. Why he becomes Baldoom, why he becomes the first Lantern, why he becomes bad guy, why this guardian, because on the beginning, on his time, everybody turned their back on Baldoom, except for this guardian. He was a good friend to him until he felt that he betrayed him. The thing is that both of them feels like they both betray one another. The thing is that they don't want to admit it, that they betray one another. It's like, you betray me, but I betray you also, but I'm not going to admit it because maybe you did it first or vice versa. So that's, I mean, this whole issue goes through that. And it's really, really good story. Really good story. So here we see that he turned into Rage. And then until he becomes Blue, the Indigo Tribe, Compassion. Right there. This is the turning point of the story. So once he becomes Blue, and then he becomes Yellow, and then he goes Orange, and back and forth, back and forth. Until he becomes... The thing is about the ring is that the ring, it feeds from your emotion, and then it will fill you with energy, kind of like a battery. The thing is that the ring will feed from emotion and put the energy into the body to a point where the body might explode, as which might happen here. That's what the ring does. It feeds from you and put energy into you until the point where the body cannot take it anymore. So finally he becomes the Indigo Tribe. Knock. Compassion Lantern. Right there. He sees, and then from there we go, we see that Baldoom and the Guardian are fighting. Okay. I mean, I like the art on this book. So awesome. Okay. So right here, we see that Frank, once that he becomes Indigo, so he realized all the bad things that he'd done, or the people that got hurt, or got killed, or how bad he feels about himself. The thing is, he got so full of compassion of himself that he decides to take off the ring himself. Check that out. So once he took it off, he realized like, wait a minute, what the hell am I doing? Why did I take off the ring? Why do I want to do that for? The thing is, at that right moment, Simons attack him and he lost the ring. Jessica runs looking for the ring, and she, to make sure that he doesn't get the ring, she put him on. Jessica puts on the ring. Now she has all those feelings all at once. Check that out. Awesome page. Now, this is the funny thing, that she did not change into any other color, but the one that she always been, a Green Lantern. Seems like that even though Jessica is the weakest one and the crazy one, seems that she's the only one who can control the ring. Believe it or not, the weakest one. The one that is always afraid. The one always get anxiety attacks. The one that always trying, that she's always trying, that she's always afraid to do this, insecure, all that. Seems like she's the only one who can control the the ring. Not only that, it give her enough confidence to create construct in a way that is supposed to be done. Ah. Believe it or not. So once that she realized that, well, look at that. I can make construct, and she take off the phantom ring and give it to Simon Bass. And she said, look, I don't need this ring anymore. And she just toss it to him. Here, take it. I don't need it anymore. I can do whatever I want. Now I can create construct the way it's supposed to be done. So the thing is that they take Frank and they put it on the statue, on the part, tie up. At that moment, the Green Lantern shows up. We see these two. Jon Stewart and some alien Green Lantern. Because at the beginning of the story, they send the signal for help. So they took long enough to arrive. So being here, they get to meet the two Green Lantern of Earth, because it seems like they never met each other. And they show him the Phantom Ring. They never heard about the Phantom Ring. They never heard of it. The thing is that, guess who shows up? The Guardian shows up with a sphere of energy. You see, according to him, when they were fighting, the Guardian and Voldoom on the apartment, when they were fighting, what's his name? The Guardian, he took Voldoom and put him inside of this kind of ball of energy or this sphere of energy. So Voldoom is inside of that energy ball. The thing is that they also give him the ring back. And they thought that he was dead. And he said, no, I was never dead. I just exiled. So what happened to Voldoom? So he just can't explain. The thing is that while he is explaining, we get to see the truth of what happened. You see, what I told you about that the Guardian putting Voldoom inside the sphere where it's the opposite. Voldoom took the Guardian, put it inside this energy sphere. So the Guardian that we're looking at is not the real Guardian. It took the shape of the real Guardian. So we see the real Guardian screaming inside the sphere, help, he's not me, I'm here. So we see him like with his mouth. So he got the ring back, he got his vengeance, he's back. Frank, I don't know what is going to happen to him, but he truly believed that he's the Phantom Lantern. So I believe that we're going to see him again. And what can I say? It was a fun story. A lot of action, a lot of story. It was real, real fast. Not like some of the story that they gave a little bit slow. Not that this one. This one was real fast. And I'm going to choose the best cover. The best cover for me will be, I like them all of them. I hate when this happens. I like this one better. Yeah. I'm going to choose this one. This is the best cover. I like it. So, this whole story arc, it was not perfect, but it was fun. It was really fun. So I will give this whole story arc. Yep. I will give this whole story arc 4.5 out of 5. And I cannot wait what's going to happen on the next story arc. So I will give it 4.5 out of 5. So if you're new into the Green Lantern books, well, I believe this is the second or third story arc. This is the second trade paperback, I believe, that they're going to publish. So you can get it maybe in floppy. or in trade paperback, but it's really good story. It's really good story. I really like it. Well, guys, this is it. I hope that you like this video. Till later. Bye.